हेलो हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडेस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू हैव ऑन फ्लूइड कैटलिटिक क्रैकिंग। लेट अस डिस्कस ऑन ऑल द टेक्निकल पैरामीटर्स एंड आल्सो द बेसिक equipments utilized in fluid catalytic cracking. Actually, this fluid catalytic cracking is designed or utilized for the production of light gas oil, heavy gas oil, and also the other petroleum products. So now I have a PowerPoint presentation on detailed design and what are the equipments utilized, process flow diagram, technical process parameters, what are the chemical changes or what are the chemical reactions that are taking place in the hydrocarbons, and also the detailed equipments design, that is heat exchanger design, and also the catalytic reactor design, and what are the catalysts utilized, and what is your final products. So these are all the procedures which are utilized in the FCC. So I have also the detailed design of catalytic reactor, that is lift reactor, cyclones, and also heat exchangers, plus other process equipments which are utilized in the fluid catalytic cracking. So now let us share you some of the basics of the fluid catalytic cracking. This is one of the downstream process in petroleum in refinery engineering. So we have upstream sector, that is which has been for drilling, reservoir, and production engineering, etc., for the production of heavy crude, that is crude oil from the wells. But here, this one we are utilizing for the after the production of oil, so you have to process it. So for this, we are doing different crude oil processing, like primary, secondary, tertiary, etc. But this one falls in the secondary processing of your crude oil. So your primary, so where you have the crude distillation unit, where it has been desalted, so you will get the diesel, kerosene, etc. In the secondary process, you will get the catalytic process, like catalytic reforming, catalytic cracking, and also so other processes. And also the tertiary processes of petroleum refinery. So we have the production of heavy oil, that is vacuum gas oil, VGO. So from the crude oil, so we have the depends on the boiling point range. So we are separating. For example, diesel, kerosene, boiling point ranges is there from 130 to 220, like that. So they have the different boiling point ranges, 350 to 500. So you will get the secondary process boiling point, where you will get the light oil, vacuum gas oil, and the tertiary process will be going on for greater than 500 degrees centigrade, where you will get the lubricants, all the oils which have very high viscosity. So this is the classification or the procedure for all the petroleum refinery processes. So what is going on in your petroleum refinery process? So let us share some of the files which I have share screen. So let us see the PowerPoint which I want to share now, just a second. So I just like to share, but let us go further about the what are the procedures utilized in the catalytic cracking process. So we have what are the equipments, or what are the, let us discuss what are the equipments. What are the equipments which are used, and what are the catalysts which are utilized? So let us start now. So in the catalytic cracking process, so there is some technical problem is there, so I could not share the file. So let us wait for, let us discuss further on the fluid catalytic cracking. See here the petroleum schematic of this fluid catalytic. So we have the generic process diagram, then we have the refinery process flow diagram. So we can see, I hope that you are able to see. See, now let us go now I will show the process flow diagram, then we will go further. So this is your process flow diagram. So you can see here the process flow diagram of fluid catalytic. We can see here the initial one is where you will get the crude oil which has been heated and sent to into the reactor with the cyclones, where it has been cracked and sent to the through the hydrocyclones, then it go to the absorption section, then your final fractionation section. So we have the three sections which are there. So we have the heating section, then catalyst processing section, or you can say the regeneration section. Then we have last one, we have the fractionation section. These are the different process flow diagrams which are utilized. So you can see here the equipments which are utilized. So please see the screen, fluid catalytic cracking technical process flow diagram. We have the distillation columns or fractionating columns. They have the fractionating columns, you have the cyclone regenerator section. That is, we call it as a reactor regenerator. So you can see the regenerator here. Then we have the products from the top of the reactor. And we'll see the later on about the what are the process parameters, how it has been utilized. So all these things. So this is riser section. So you can see here process parameters we'll discuss later on. And now the light end process, what you are getting here. So what are the process which you are so once again, so there will be some issues with the lightning. Once again, so now we can see the hello. So I hope that now we can see the presentation. So what are the, let us go from the basics of your block diagram. So this is your crude oil, where you will get the where it has been heated, and this goes to the distillation. This is your primary distillation process. So here you'll get the butadiene, then you'll get the naphtha, then crude distillation unit, then you'll get the diesel, hydro treatments, so you'll get the catalytic cracking. So all these things. So now we are concentrating on FCC process. So what you will get there? So you will get the low value gas oils to valuable products. So you are getting, converting the low gas oils or low value gas oils to the valuable products like naphtha, diesel and slurry. So what is the techniques? So what are the process steps? First one, so the gas oil dispersed in the bottom of the riser. So you can see the process flow diagram. You can see here in the process flow diagram at the bottom of the riser using the steam. So steam has been used in the bottom of the riser. Then next one, second point, thermal cracking occurs on the surface of the catalyst. So there will be a thermal cracking which has been happening in the surface of the catalyst, and also the disengaging of the drum that separates the spent catalyst from the product, because the here the catalyst is recycled. So there will be a disengaging of the drum which separates the spent catalyst from the product. Then next one, fourth one, so you have the stem strips, that is the the steam strips and the residual hydrocarbons from the spent catalyst. So that is the fourth point. Then the air also burns the carbon flame over a partial burnt or full burnt. Then the sixth one, regenerated catalyst enters the bottom of the riser reactor. So this is your primary process technique. Then you can see here the typical process yields. So what are, so you are getting the light ends six yield of the percentage, that is 16.5 to 22, then which is used for the you're getting the LPG and the alkalis and naphtha 44 to 56% naphtha hydro treating. Then light crude oil 13 to 20, then distillate hydro treatments, medium cycle oil, then you are getting the slurry oil and coke. So now this is your process tank. So now you can see here the feed has been sent to the reactor through the heat exchanger. So here heating section where the gases, flue gases also sent, and this is your drum, regenerated drum, and this is your cyclone. So you are getting the, this is your reactor regenerator section. So you can see the reactor, this is the regenerator, and the top of the column. So you are getting that products just sent to the fractionating section. So this is a typical process flow diagram. And this is your next slide, is your modern riser reactor unit, also one of the modern units. Then the next one, we have the advanced one. So you can see here the advanced one. So where you can see the, where you can explain, where you can learn very clearly, where you can see all the sections of the reactor. So you can see here the steam and air which has been passed from the section 1 and 2, that is 1 and 2, the combustion air sent into the regenerator. Then we have the electrostatic precipitators, then catalytic separators, then it has been sent into the regenerator. So what is the process parameter? So we have the process parameter of 715 degree centigrade and 2.41. This is your pressure and the feedstock. So where you are getting from, where you are going through the feedstock. So this is your feedstock, that is your from cold oil, where you are getting 315 to 430 degree centigrade, which has been sent to through this line. So this is the regenerator section, that is total feed through the pump will be sent here. And here CO stands for carbon monoxide, cooling water is there, steam, then condensate. See, CO stands for carbon monoxide through the boiler. Then you have the flue gases which has been sent, the temperature of the regenerator. You can see the small units. So number one is your startup steam turbine. The second one is your air compressor. Then you have electric generators. Then we have the number four turbo generator. Then we have the number five is your cyclone. So this is your number five is your cyclone. You can see here. Then other equipment. So catalyst withdrawal well is there, number six. Then catalyst riser, number seven, catalyst number seven stands, that is catalyst riser. Then number nine, spent catalyst sidewalls are released. So this is your distillation column. So here you can see this, what are the produced gas are sent into the bottom of the, and the top, the, again the product has been condensed at 38 degree centigrade with pressure 0.56, sends to the reflex drum. Then again it has been to heat the top of the column. You can see here again the reflex, part of the reflex has been sent back, and the distillation column and cracked to naphtha. So this is the typical process flow diagram of advanced fluid catalytic cracking process. And see now the most see here, this is your regenerator, this is your reactor. So you just see this in the flow diagram, where it is goes, how this catalytic cracks. So the spent catalyst again recycled and sent into the regenerator, and the product is produced from your top of your reactor and sent to the distillation column or fractionation column, where it will produce the cracked naphtha, fuel oil, slurry oil. So this is the this like this you have to learn the process flow diagram of the typical catalytic cracking unit. So here been done. So now let us, we have now learned, we have just listened now what are the process flow diagram, so what are the equipments, how this has been the feedstock has been cracked and then sent into the reactor. So now let us see what are the description. So now we are discussing only the simple reviews, overall view. Now what is happening? So the why we are use this FCC, most common process for FCC is, so the oil which you are getting the crude 315 to 430 degree centigrade boiling point feed or oil is cracked with the help of the catalyst or catalyst finely divide catalyst. So we can say it's a fluidized bed state. So here it will be in the fluidized bed state. So the fluid cracker is consists of a, as I told you, catalyst section, then fractionating section of the integrated process unit. So where is your catalyst section? So this is your catalyst section of your process diagram. So what's happening in the catalyst section? So this section, we have the reactor. So you can see the reactor and regenerator. So you can see the reactor and the, so the catalyst regenerator with the help of one standpipe and riser in the form of catalyst circulation unit. So the there will be a fluid catalyst. What is happening? The fluid catalyst continuously related, and the air is oil vapor and the steam as the conveying media. So the third point, let us see here the, so this is the one. So the control system also explained here. You can see here flue gases, regenerator, reactor, and your feedstock has been sent to the bottom of the reactor. Then next one. So these are all the typical process flow diagrams. So what are the configuration? So what you are getting? So what are the products you are getting in the typical? So you are getting the feedstock of deaspirated oil, gas oil. So you are getting in the process. So you will get the your middles products. What are the products you will get? The middle distillates or blends or other petroleum residuals. Then, so now let us go for the, so now let's go for the FCC, the reactor regenerator. So you can see here reactor section number of the one, and then second is the extraction section, then wet gas compressor section. So there are three sections are there where the catalytic process has been utilized. So you can see here, this is the point where lower bottom of the section, and then your dispersed steam with your catalyst are injected with along with air, then it goes through the lift reactor or riser reactor. From here you are having the regenerated section where it is gone to the riser. So it means lift reactor. So it takes lifting all these things to the stripping streams, and we have cyclones here, and reactor effluents are taken back. So this diagram also will explain more. So you can see here regenerator, stripping stream, then riser, generator, regenerator section, and your catalyst, regenerated catalyst, which are sent back for recycling. So here this also, this slide number 21, so you can see more clearly. Then FCC catalyst and chemistry. So let us come for the catalyst chemistry. So you have the zeolites, which are used in the, so this is the structure of silicates, zeolites, which is the composition of silica and aluminia. Now what is the, so now we are some chemical engineering. So now we can see the Arrhenius theory, Arrhenius law of energy. So you can see the how the effect of collision theory, all these things you would learn. So it is speed up the rate of the reaction. So why you are using catalyst, and also why you are using, so because catalyst speed up the rate of the reaction. So your chemical reaction engineer is coming. So Arrhenius theory, so you can see the collision result in the product formation. So lowering the energy of activation and more collision result in the product formation. So this is the effect of catalyst. So you can use the your chemical reaction engineering where the activation energy is for the energized reactions and products, progress of the reaction versus energy. So this is another way. And now the zeolite process, silica aluminia, this is the process of primary source of catalytic activities are taken by porous silica alumina catalysts, and this is your zeolite catalyst. And what is the chemistry? So now let's go for the reaction, catalytic reaching. So what is the overall reaction? So overall reaction taking place, so paraffin, olefin, and you will get the catalytic cracking. So overall reaction, paraffin, olefin plus shorter olefin will give the alkane. So we can see here the structure, paraffin, you will get the olefins and paraffin. So this FCC converts the gas oils and the heavy stocks into high octane gasoline. So you will get the high octane. So what is the high octane? High octane number. So you will get the knocking properties of the fuel, you should be knowing. So you will get the high, converts the gas oils into heavy stocks into high octane gasolines and light fuel oil gases, in which is containing the more olefins. So the following products are produced from the catalytic cracking unit. So we'll get the gas, unstabilized gasoline, LCO, light cycle oil, that is heavy cycle oil, and slurry oil, SLO. So these are the three products. So light gas oil, heavy cycle oil, or slurry oil. See now, see what is the reaction. See now, the hydrocarbon molecules are, you can see the catalytic reaction. We have fairly random way to products, so mixture of carbons and some of which are carbon-carbon double bonds. So you can see the example of hydrocarbon C18 or H. C15, H32, so on zeolite catalyst, so you will get the formed. So from the hydrocarbon, simple one, so you will get the formed double bonds, alkenes. Then, so this is the chemistry and conversion. So the heavy oils, catalyst, you will get the fuel gas, naphtha and distillates. So these are the processes, products which are getting and yields. So you can see here, FCC products and yields, sir. Same one. Then, so what are the again? So let's this slide shows the slide number 31. So you'll get the gas oil product. So you'll get the air cyclones, then gas oil, you'll get the product. Then there are a lot of techniques are there. Ortho flow, what is mean by ortho flow? So now in this old FCC process, what you are getting? So we are getting the all in separate units like lift generator, reactor. So you are getting catalyst section separate, then everything separate. But there is a modern unit, one ortho flow FCC unit. So where you will get the everything, the compact. So you can see all in single unit. So that is the ortho flow FCC. So what is mean by ortho flow description? So it includes the compact and self-supporting converter. So you are getting the stripper and regenerator efficiently combined in a single vessel. So you are getting in a single vessel. So typical FCC. So you can see here, see the ortho flow disengager. So riser reactor, you have the riser quench. So you have the regenerator. Then you have the feed section is there. So you can see here, all combined in the single vessel. See your PowerPoint, the slide. So you can see hydrocarbon to closed cycle system and you are shipping. So what is is technology in compacting all the stripping, convert everything in a single vessel. So the so what is the advantage? So we are using this with the help of using the space. So the entire pressure containing shell is of cold wall carbon steel construction with modern monolithic refractory. See, monolithic refractory, it is like a ceramic. So these are two walls which are used. So you have the cold wall carbon steel construction with modern monolithic refractory. Then cold wall construction provides longer services. So what is happening? Because this cold wall gives you a longer duration and also low cost because of insulation. The refractory keeps the steel shell in the optimum temperatures range. So you are saying that this will help us to make the procedure optimum and maximum strength and avoidance of thermal degradation. So there will be no thermal degradation, or you can say that changes in temperature, no change in temperature or no change in the fluctuation of temperature or thermal degradation which happens. So this is the NOx. Another, this is about the so FCC ortho flow is the modern design where it is differ from the old one. Now 35. So you can see the FCC generator with NOx, nitrogen oxide. So in this spent catalyst, the distributed across the top of the regenerator bed. So in the other one, so we are putting in the bottom, but now here you can say that evenly distributed across the top of the generator bed, causing a this chemical reaction, carbon plus nitrogen with CO plus N2. So they are saying only 5 to 7% of the coke is escapes and the remaining is harmless nitrogen by the already the reaction spent. So this is the KBR company which is patent with the help of this So what is the system? Benefits of the system is the NOx emissions. So when you produce the FCC cracking, so they are reduction of nitrogen emissions and optimal catalyst, bed density, distribution, etc. etc. Then elimination of need or amount of FCC fluid gases post treatment of fluiding gases. See, now closed cyclones. See, now next slide. So you can see here. Your next slide, 46 slide. The effective removal of the product from the FCC converter has been cracked. So there, this slide shows the conversion. So how you are removing the product vapors from the FCC converter after the cracking. Once the feed is having the desired yield, how much is conversion rate, yield, how much. So that is the one. In the modern FCC unit, see, this is in the riser. Once, see, this is also Exxon KBR, post cyclone technology, a new technology. So, and all the theory in the refineries like in CPCL or Bangalore or other refineries, you are having the only the open cyclone, but here this closed cyclone is very typical improved one. Then, so we have the next slide, 37. So you have the regenerated catalyst standpipe, spent catalyst standpipe, vertical slope maximum of 45. So these are the design, all the parameters, cold or hot one. So catalyst velocity 2 to 6 feet, density. So how will you start? So next is, suppose you have the plant operation. Now you understand the catalyst, fluid catalytic cracking process. But now, so what do you understand? So what do you understand in the first step in the starting a plant? Plant startup in the FCC. So what do you do first? So the first step of the plant is to set up a fluidized bed in the reactor and the generator with the aid of a hot air and heat. So they will send the hot air and heat catalyst by injecting the fuel into the regenerator. Then second point, after achieving bed depth, once you do the startup, all this thing, then startup. So what are the checklists? So what is the startup operation checklist? So these are the operation checklist. Pre-startup check, then regenerator, then we have regenerator, then we have regenerator catalyst additions, then regenerator torch oil firing, reactor catalyst circulation, then main reactor bottom, then main fractionator. So these are the place you can start up operation checklist. bottom vaccination both second. So you have to be thorough with your process flow diagram. Flow diagram well. So you are able to do the design very well. So for this, yeah, what you should do? We should know the basics of your what are the equipments used, then what are the process parameter, where it is taking place, where it is cracked, where it has been increased temperature, why it is reducing, why there is a thermal degradation. So all these factors. So for that, this is a fractionator. So you have the section of start LCO, HCO, then you have the load increase to design conditions. So now this is your simple control system. Now you may ask this is the next slide on number 40. See now. So we have the hydrocarbon vapor refrigerator, the control system, how it has been controlled. So temperature control, the TRO, temperature regulator. So this is your instrumentation part. So your process dynamics, process control, you can design your see what are the, so this is your country FCC. Now let's go to the next one, FCCR controls. So what are the major in the so there are FCC itself. So it contains the catalyst circular shown in the circulation rates, which are shown in this diagram. Then the reactor temperature, how you control the reactor temperature by a valve. So how do you control? So you control the help of the valve. So where it allows the hot and regenerated catalyst to flow into the reaction zone. So you can control the temperature. Then stripper level. So you can see the stripper level also, the second major control, the FCC wall at the spent catalyst. So you can see in the base of the spent catalyst pipe. Then the reactor generator differential pressure controller is the final major control. Reactor differential pressure control is the major control of the FCC. Then this control operates the free gas slide valve to maintain the safe differential pressure between the reactor and generator. See now, as a part of chemical engineer or process engineering, so we are now taking the special topic on fluid catalytic cracking. Now we can see here let us go for the next slide. That is 42, pressure balance. So you can see the pressure balance calculation works the reactor. So what do you take? So now you have to understand what is the react temperature, then what is the static head pressure, then stripper, what has been attached. So all this you can see here in this so now let us go for the next important, that is your next slide, that is pressure and density profile in fluid catalytic cracking. So this is very important. So this is standpipe, head is driving force. So here you will be involved all your my heat transfer or whatever it is. We can. So here you can see the low pressure level, in the so generated 0.3 to 3.0 level is showing through 2.7 P is pressure 0.3 here also in the pipes. So this is your all the driving force for the catalyst also there. The riser, see 0.4 delta P and the density profile 300 to 400 kg per meter cube for catalyst movement. So density, pressure, profile in the FCC. It's a very important because good profile on your pressure or density, then only so all the things will be done properly. So you can see a delta P regenerate 0.3 to 3. Now heat balance. So this is your this slide about the density profile. Now let's go for the. So what do you see in the heat balance? So in the heat balance, you have to see the quantity of the feed, how much, then property of process feed, then circulating catalyst properties and temperature of combined feed, then temperature at discharge of the lift reactor, then relation of combined feed, regenerated temperature, then catalyst feed ratio, coke production. Now, FCC process variables. Now, these are which are shown here is now process variables, process parameters. So alkane cycle, so hydrocarbon content. So what do you have in your hydrocarbon feedstock? So you have the medium arenes, so all are gasoline, sulfur also there. Then you have alkenes plus alkenes, the variation range percentage by weight T8. So you can see here ASTM 1060 degrees centigrade. So you have T10, T50, T90. So these are the ranges of proper catalyst area. So what do you understand? So you should know the properties of catalyst, equilibrium catalyst. So you see the content of nickel and apparent bulk density or coke generators percentage by weight is shown. Then process parameters. So how much feedstock per hour? So 100 to 170 ton per hour. Then discharge temperature of the lift reactor, feedstock temperature. Then we have the regenerated temperature, catalyst temperature in ratio between. So this table shows the quality of fresh feedstock of very close range can be accepted as a constant. So the ratio of the combined feed and other things are depending on the heat balance. So now let's go to the heat balance. So you can design later on in your project about the design of the reactor or whatever it is. So now we are able to in this 1 hour, it is very short time, so it will be difficult to explain. Now we are going to conclude till, let's we finish now heat balance reactor. How will you do that? can see this one. This end heat of the air from will blow at this temperature, then common the glasses from the regenerator. So the heat transfer provide feedstock, then heating in the riser. So wet balance maximum. So you are breaking of the oil. So all these things you have to calculate. See this one feed 230 degree centigrade. Spent catalyst 500 degree centigrade, then regenerated catalyst 700, then reactor product 510 degree centigrade. By the burning coke and heat consumed in the and the independent variables like temperature, feed temperature, then recycle temperature, then dependent variables, etc. So now spent catalyst is 500 degree centigrade and catalyst the heat combustion, then losses in the heat balance for the regenerator. Spent catalyst, heat of combustion, and at 250, so you'll get the balance of heat losses, flue gases. Now next is very important, catalyst. So the fluid cladding process, what is catalyst circulation ratio? So that is catalyst circulation rate directly influencing the regenerator temperature. Catalyst oil equal to catalyst circulation rate and T by hour equal to feed rate by time per hour. So catalyst oil ratio increase catalyst divided by oil ratio you are doing. So by increasing the reactor temperature and reducing the combined feed temperature, feed nozzles dispersions and improved feed quality and lowering the boiling ranges. So catalyst to oil ratio and catalyst circulation rate is different as oil ratio is different. Then probably most common FCC problems. So the most common troubleshoots encountered in the operation of FCC includes the catalyst fluidization and flow instability in the reactor, then poor stripping, poor regeneration and catalyst losses through cyclones and poor reaction and maintenance of catalyst. So now we can, those who are familiar with the fluidization principles, so the fluidized bed is formed when a quantity of solid substance is placed under appropriate condition to cause the solid and fluid. This is our introduction of pressurized fluid through the particulate medium. So this will be result in the properties and characteristics of the fluids which will be flowing freely. Type technologies. So this resulting phenomenon is called fluidization, or fluidized beds are used for several bed reactor types, fluid bed conditions. So the mass transfer principles. So you have to see the calculations. You will see the fluidized bed reactor calculations. A design we will go later on for fluidized bed calculation. So here you will have the mass transfer principles. So this is your fluidized bed design. So you can see the fluidized bed reactor, gas, source bubbles, and your gas solid and your distributor. So this is the principle of fluidized bed. So this is your the fluidized bed. See here, heat etching tubes are there, then cyclones, then A reactant gas. So here fluid is bed design of your reactor. Then what is that troubleshooting problem? So here the problem is that main problem is catalyst and ratio. Usually the problem is solved operating parameters or change in the catalyst physical will be discussed in the troubleshooting of circulation problems, the pressure balance and dynamics which control the fluid catalytic cracking units, which must be can understand in this diagram, in these slides. Then troubleshooting, how we can tell, how we can say that this unit is under your problem. So the most obvious indication of the problem with the catalyst circulation is that there will be a dramatic or very sharp drop fluctuation in the pressure drop across the both of the catalyst and control valves. Then the entry system of the AC and other parameters should be considered, general lines, then to distribute flow. So this RV should be make clear in the vertical standpipe. Then next guidelines are generation difficulties in the stand and understanding the dynamics of the FCC and also their main proper pressure balance of operation. And so the features FCC fractionator, heat transfer section, say heat transfer. So number 64 explains the heat removal first, the distillation or fractionating column, and high vapor velocities and the catalytic solids in the feed which are present during the, and vapor from 520-309, and this is also the of your fractionating. So what is the fractionator data? So you can see this is top of RH liquid, then volume factor, F factor, flooding. So these are all fractionator data which in the so distillation principle, so you think pressure related to boiling components from the separation of the components from the so how you're getting, so you're getting the distillation principles from the principles, the separation of components from a liquid mixture by a difference being passed, and also the depending on the concentration of the component present and the distillation depends on the vapor pressure characteristics of the liquid. So this one distillation principle, you establish the mole fraction, bubble point, and so let us see the high pressure. So boiling point diagram, you are establishing dew point, bubble temperature, So please go through the this one and lecture and our 1 hour lecture has been concluded. Then we will go for next class. Thank you.